Now, as far as the 75% gain group is concerned, so following are the implications. Assets can be transferred between the group members tax efficiently. And similarly, you can also transfer efficiently the capital losses, and rollover relief is to be used effectively as well. Now, what is the gain group? So as far as the definition is concerned, so in order to be a gain group, there must be a parent company, and the parent must have a 75% shareholding in all the subsidiaries, and the 75% subsidiary have first subsidiary and so on. It means that parent has subsidiary and subsidiary has also subsidiaries that can be part of the group. And parent company must have effective interest over 50% in all companies. So if a parent has a subsidiary having 75% shares, and that subsidiary has any other subsidiary having 75% of the shares, then the effective interest must not be 75%, rather it would be only above 50%. The subsidiary cannot form a separate group because there must be a parent for a group. Shares held by overseas companies can be taken into account, but you cannot transfer the benefit to the overseas companies. For example, A Limited acquired 75% shares of B Limited, and so B Limited acquired 75% shares, and then C Limited acquired 75% shares. State which companies form the gain group, and also state which companies form the group loss relief group. Now, as far as the gain group is concerned, so we can say that we have to calculate the percentage. So let's see the effective percentage. So A has 75% shares in B. Similarly, B has 75% shares. So effectively, A has 75% and 75% multiplied by 75%. So you can easily identify that how much is the shares available. Let me just calculate that how much shares is available in that company. So the effective percentage is 56.25%. So parent has more than 50% shares. But as far as the C and D is concerned, the effective percentage is only 42.19%. That is 75 into 75 into 75. So that means D is not part of the gain group. And B cannot prepare a separate group because a parent is required. So the gain group comprises of A, B, and C. And no other companies can form a separate gain group. Now, as far as the loss relief group is concerned, so there are different rules, and parent must have effective interest of 75%. So in this way, there are different loss group. For example, AB is a separate loss group. Similarly, BC is a separate loss group, and CD is a separate loss group. Because effective interest must be 75% in order to create a separate group. Now, if a company is part of a gain group, then what is the implication? Then assets are transferred between the group at no gain, no loss. If a company is selling an asset to another group company, then there will be no gain or loss. Chargeable gain and allowable losses can be transferred around the group. So group capital gain tax liability can be easily minimized. Rollover relief is available on group basis. One company sell the asset, other company acquire another asset, and they can get the rollover relief. Transfer of asset within the group are automatically transferred at no gain, no loss. And this transfer is automatic and mandatory. When assets sold outside the group, there will be normal gain or loss arises. For example, G Limited acquired a building on 1st April 1996 for 100,000. And that building was transferred to Jade Limited, a wholly owned subsidiary, on 1st October 2006 for 1,20,000 when the market worth was 1,80,000. On 1st December, the Jade Limited sold the building outside the group for 3,50,000. Calculate chargeable gain, if any, arising on the transfer of building between the group and sale of building outside the group. Relevant indexation factors are there. Following indexation factors are not beneficial because they are after 31st December 2017. So these are irrelevant. So we have to find out the relevant indexation factor. So first of all, the transfer between the group companies. So the cost was, the original cost was 100,000, and indexation between the date of purchase and the date of first sale. So it's 1996 till October 2006. So the relevant indexation allowance is 0.313, that is 31,300. So the cost becomes 131,300, and that becomes deemed proceed in order to create no gain, no loss. Now, as far as the sale of building on December 19 is concerned, the sale proceed is 3,50,000 outside the group minus the deemed cost, which is after considering the indexation allowance, that is 131,300, and a unindexed gain is 218,700. Now we have to incorporate the indexation allowance, which is freezed at 31st December 2017 from October 2006. So the relevant indexation factor is 131,300 multiplied by 0.388. That is from October 16 to 31st December. As a result, the cost indexation allowance is 50,944 and the value is 167,756. This is the chargeable gain. And this is to be paid by the company that is selling it outside the group. Election to transfer gain or loss. In order to transfer gain or losses, member of the capital gain group can make a joint election to transfer gain or loss to other companies in the group. So group can plan to maximize the use of capital losses as early as possible without having to make an actual transfer of an asset. So actual transfer is not needed. Without having actual transfer, you can also get the benefit. You can maximize the use of capital losses. The claim must be made within 2 years of the accounting period in which gain or loss arises. And current year gain and loss can be transferred, not the brought forward. So if there are any brought forward losses, then you have to offset it with the current gain with your same company. Benefits of joint transfer election. There will be a saving in legal and administrative cost. Tax planning can be undertaken retrospectively because there are 2 years, so you can easily plan how to settle the gain or losses. And partial transfer is allowed, so there is flexibility in that. You can easily plan that how much loss can be transferred between the group companies. Now, as far as the group rollover relief is concerned, so from the individual company's concept, we know that what is rollover relief. A rollover relief is there when you sell an asset and within a qualifying period you bought another qualifying asset. Both the asset must be qualified, then you can defer the gain and you to offset with the base, make it base cost, and then you can defer for a time period against the disposal of the new asset. But in case of the group, companies within the group are considered as a single company. So it means that ROR can be claimed where one company dispose of an eligible asset and make a chargeable gain, while another company in the groups acquire a replacement eligible asset within the available time frame. For example, ABC Limited sold a factory for 600,000 in 19. Cost of the original asset was 200,000 and relevant indexation was 65,000. ABC Limited owns 75% of XYZ Limited, so that creates a member of the group. And XYZ bought a warehouse costing 750,000 in the year ended December 2020. And that is a qualifying period. Calculate chargeable gain arising on the sale of factory, assuming all reliefs are taken, and calculate the base cost of the warehouse. Now, in this case, the sale proceed is 600,000. The original cost is 200,000. So there is an unindexed gain of 400,000. Indexation allowance given in the question, 65,000. So indexed gain is 335,000. Now, as the whole proceed more than the reinvestment is more than the proceed, so the whole gain is to be deferred, claimed as ROR, 335,000. In this case, the chargeable gain becomes zero. The partial rule will be applicable if part of the amount is not reinvested. Now, the base cost of the purchasing company, so their original cost is 750,000. They will deduct the ROR of the selling company from their asset. In this way, the base cost is 415,000, and that is to be used for subsequent disposal. So in this way, it is very beneficial that you can easily utilize the ROR with the other capital gain group companies.